Whatever you're doing, I cannot be a part of. This is murder. I can't let you do this.
It's already done.
He says he sold the pub. But we fought so hard to get this place back.
I'm sorry, son.
Who the hell do you think you are?
They're my guests. In fact, we're their guests. Their dad's bought the pub.
I'll have a sin.
I need to get rid of this body.
Do you mind opening the boot, sir?
Freddy. The undertaker's gonna fly Charlie's body over so we can bury him near where he used to work. In paradise. Surprise.
Are you sure it's what he wanted?
Yeah, me and Charlie used to talk about Sierra Leone all the time.
Is it Leone?
Obviously.
And it'd be safe, yeah?
Yeah. We'll make sure we are now. In the cab.
The body was discovered yesterday afternoon. Arrests have been made, but the victim has not yet been named. And enough.
Freddie's dead.
You are?
Freddy's dead.
Trevor. Trevor killed Freddy.
He was found in the boot of Trevor's car.
Freddy's dead.
What did you just say? Sorry, Zig, but last night, Trevor...
No. I saw Freddy in hospital, right? He was fine.
How did he die?
We don't know yet.
What do you mean you don't know? What, was it a gun or what?
I said we don't know yet, Robbie. The post-mortem will tell us more.
What are you doing with champagne?
Early morning bubbles, celebrate a new beginning.
It ripped.
Hi.
Listen, everyone, I'm so sorry about this mess. I'm Matt Nightingale. How are you? Jack, good to see you again,
and
mate.
And you, Mike. Good to see you, kid.
The boy with the exploding beanbag is my younger son, Alfie. And Jack, I think you've already met my other son, Nathan.
Morning.
And this is Rachel, his fiance.
Hiya.
So, where is she? And that is my beautiful daughter. You got that jeans,
Can somebody help me out here? Don't dare!
Oh. It's clean.
Oh, yeah, so was this. And a bit of downside more expensive than your polyester tap.
Whoa. There you go, we've got to unpack. I don't know if you noticed, but Tintin there just fizzed up on me. I need a shower.
Sorry. Yeah, sorry.
Anyway, everyone, welcome to the village.
Mark, I'll get you a fresh bottle of champagne.
Oh, no worries.
Right, the keys.
Tom.
And I've got something else for you. Every new owner of the dog gets ceremoniously presented with its lucky charm. And I hope you and your family will be just as happy here as I've been with mine.
Well, I never. I haven't seen this for a long, long time.
You've seen it before?
Oh, yeah. Merlin was such a good dog.
Merlin?
I think it's about summer, first up. The dog in the pond. Well, that was my dog.
I can't do this.
Yes, you can. You have to.
Yeah. What's up? Why have you all got that face?
Lynch, don't you know?
Freddy's dead.
No. Today is a good day.
Miss that smile.
Watch where you're going.
You watch where you're going. I wonder what you just got these.
eamed it up a bit. I'm Alfie, by the way.
Oh, it's okay. Oh, Pez! Perry!
I am glad I have seen you. Listen, I didn't know whether you were going to be at the dog or where you'd be today.
What do you want?
Well, but your dad's in court tomorrow, and we'll find out how long he's going to go to prison for.
I hope he gets life.
Right. Well, listen, I was thinking, if you wanted to, we could go together.
I'd rather stick pins in my eyes. Perry, please! Perry!
Ow! Ow! Oh, he's doing! He's gonna give me a heart attack!
What are you doing?
I live here, and you're breaking in.
Lockie, I've got a key, son. My whole family are moving in.
Cool. I mean, well, he's been into the whole hippie commune lifestyle. I mean, do you guys do wife swapping? I don't have a wife, but...
No, listen. I'm renting this place from Dirk until the mortgage comes through. I'm afraid you're going to have to leave.
When are you moving in?
Now.
Do you want some cake when we move into the new house?
Charlie, what about you?
I'm not hungry.
Hey, what's wrong? Are you worried about moving? I know it's all a bit sudden, but Frankie and Jack are moving too, and don't you think it's about time we had a nice place to ourselves? You know, just you, me and Oscar.
What's stopping you now?
So, good question.
Well, let's have a look, shall we? Cozy two-bed flat with garden in need of TLC. Well, they won't get that from you, will they?
Don't be horrible.
Oh, here's another one, look. Three-bed flat to share with one other, would suit single female. No dogs. Oh, what a shame.
Darren, why are you being like this?
Why don't you have a look yourself?
Hey, what is wrong with you?
Oh, I don't know. Between finding out that Freddy's dead and you taking my kids away, I have no idea.
Sorry.
I don't want your pity, OK? It doesn't change anything. You want to move out with the kids?
Oh, well, come on. You can't be thrilled about the idea of shacking up with me either. I mean, what's living with the ex going to do with your sex life?
I don't know. Probably better than when we were together. Ow.
Charlie? Where's Charlie gone? Darren, he's gone.
Oh, Mum, please don't cry. I know. It just... Listen, I'll call you back later, yeah? Okay, love you too. Bye.
Oh, Lindsay, you poor thing. I just found this. Freddie never put his clothes in the laundry basket and there was always piles of dirty clothes everywhere. It still smells of him. I don't know what's happening to me.
Just come here.
I just keep thinking if things had been different, maybe it wouldn't have ended up like this.
None of this is your fault, Lindsay. Whether you two were together at the end or not, you're going to be thinking about a lot of what-ifs for a while. We all are. It's not your fault, okay?
I can't believe it. Yesterday he was here.
Rob, you all right, son?
Yeah. No, it's just, reminds me of Dad and Phoebe, you know, thinking that they're going to get better and then... I mean, this is different, isn't it? You know. Freddie was murdered.
Listen, DS Thorpe told me about this theory Cindy had about the hospital.
Cindy?
I know, Joe, it's probably nothing. One of us needs to make themselves useful, don't they?
Hey, are you okay? You were doing so well. He's dead. And he's not coming back. I'm never going to see him again. I don't understand.
He would still be alive if he wasn't such a stupid, weak. My husband is dead. Why did
he? He was going to leave me.
For that bitch!
And now Jason is going to ruin everything.
Oh, come on, Lindsay, come on. Deep breath, breathe.
We're going to investigate the hospital and then what?
Why, I go to jail because of Freddie's lies.
Shh.
it's all Freddy's fault. Anything that happens is because of him.
Where are you going?
I have to stop Jason!
No, you need to calm down. We will shut Jason down, but I need you to calm down. Okay, breathe. Breathe. I am not going to leave you, Lindsay. I know that I've been out of control and I've done some mad stuff recently, but I'm going to look after you. Your big little sister. Okay, but you need to keep it together. Can you do that for me?
Please don't leave me.
I'm sorry, mate. Must be a dodgy pump. Can I get you a bottle beer instead?
Here, have this one.
Nice one. Thanks.
Well, I'm glad that us moving here was based on a sound business decision and not a trip down memory lane. Oh, hang about.
Now, you just wait a second, son. Now, you are going to have your best memories in here, just like your dad did. You're going to love it. You're starting off at a new college. You're setting up home with the woman of your dreams.
I want to know what happened to Merlin the dog.
Merlin. Merlin was such a hero. He saved this little boy from drowning in the pond, but he never made it out himself. So my dad renamed this pub in his memory.
Excuse us, mate.
Come on.
Think about saving him from drowning.
And then he said, "Don't mind about the nuts. They're complimentary."
There is something going on here, Linz.
You need to stop that.
Do you not want to know if there's a serial killer in the hospital?
Look, Jace, the police have already been here, all right? They've searched everywhere. Listen to yourself. Serial killers, conspiracy theories. Freddie deserves more than that, all right? His body turned up in a boot of a car and you want to make him some part of a horrible slasher movie?
What is the worst that can happen if I don't find anything, eh? I will look like an idiot, Linz. I can handle that.
Jason, stop, all right? Nothing you do is going to bring him back. He's gone, Jack.
I know he's gone! But I don't know what else to do, Lindsay!
Come on. You're here.
I'm sorry.
Where are you going?
I'm going home.
What are you doing here? You thought I was going to kill Jason.
Daddy, why are you torturing yourself?
I don't know what you're talking about.
So you're telling me that you're not checking for non-existent messages from Nita?
No, no, of course not. Ellie, just shut up. Nita, hi. Only me. Look, I don't know why I'm really calling you, but I miss you, darling. Hello? Hello? Anyone there? Whoa! All right, little fella? You gave me a bit of a shock then. It's Charlie, isn't it? Charlie, I'm Mac. Listen, I've got something for you, all right? Roast chicken crisps. Not everyone's favourite, but I love them. There you go. Right, Charlie, I think I better get you home. You come with me? Good lad. Hey.
So,
tomorrow.
Look, the judge might be super lenient. We might be out in the pints tomorrow night.
There is no chance of me being anywhere but here tomorrow night. Nor do I deserve it.
Come on, man. You gotta stay positive. Can't just give up.
Right, what's happened?
What do you mean?
That something's happened. I can see it in your face, old brother of mine.
Oh, I'm slightly homeless. You know me, I've got friends. Oh, Cam. Look, I'm useless without you. I need you, and I think you need me. We sort each other out.
Yeah, I know. But what am I meant to do about it?
Look, I'm gonna get you out of here.
I'm sorry about earlier, okay? I just had a bit of a crazy day.
No, I'm sorry too. I haven't even asked you anything about Freddy. I just can't think about anything.
Delivery.
Charlie!
Hey.
Okay.
Hey.
Oh, where the hell have you been? Don't you ever do that to me again.
I found Litlin here in my cellar, keeping an eye on things. I hope I haven't scared him, because, I can't get a word out of him.
Why do you run off like that, eh?
Charlie, say something.
Pez?
What are you doing down there?
Look, I won't pressure you to talk to me. I know that tomorrow's a big deal. Not everything's always about you, you know.
Mister.
Right. Well, now I am going to pressure you to talk to me.
What's up?
You know, Charlie went missing at the Osbournes today. And everyone was so upset. It just made me realise that if Steph wasn't there anymore, then I'd be relieved. How horrible am I?
Hey, look, don't be so hard on yourself. Harry, you've got postnatal depression.
Is it still postnatal depression if I am perfectly fine when she's not around?
But the PND, it can make you feel those things. It's a really weird illness. I'm gonna book you in with a psychiatrist tomorrow.
I can't believe you thought I'd killed Jason.
Really? Why not? You have just killed your own husband.
Girls, come here a minute. We realised that if there was one thing Freddie loved more than anything in the world, it was you, Lindsay. And even though he's gone, we want you to know you're still part of the family.
So, Lindsay, why don't you move back in with us? With Kim and JJ.
Seriously, if it weren't for you, I'd still be on some stupid rampage around the hospital. We all need each other right now.
Please.
Okay.
You're about to do something gross where I'm about to eat this lasagna, weren't you?
A little bit.
It is still rammed out there. Who's going to serve while we're having dinner?
We've been working all day. How about you, Els?
I'm a beauty therapist, not a barmaid.
Look who's here to save the day.
You've already done that, Mac.
I don't know what would have happened to Charlie if he'd been left in that cellar any longer. I can't get a single word out of him now.
Oh, we'll be all right, Jack. Kids react strangely to things sometimes, I mean.
Yeah.
Look, I'm really glad you came over. To be honest with you, I could do with a little bit of help in a bar. Maybe a refresher course.
Yeah, no worries. Look, why don't you have your dinner first with the kids? Meet me in the bar later.
Oh, sort of, man. Thanks, Jack.
Cheers. See you later, guys.
See ya.
So many carbs.
You got any wine?
Yeah, I'll get it.
You feeling happier now that we're going to stay here with Darren?
I'm sorry we were so horrible to each other earlier. Is that why you ran off? Charlie, you know, you can talk to me. Tell me what's got you so scared. Okay. Be back in a minute.
Okay.
He's still not talking.
You might want to get that.
Free for a quick chat.
Yeah, I've got to get back to the boys. Listen, I'll see you later on, yeah?
Mwah. I'll call you.
Yeah.
Well, let me guess. You're here to talk about Cam's sentencing.
I went to see him. Lee, I can't think what another spell inside will do to him.
Do you know what, Lockie? I don't even know what you're about to ask me, right? But please, stop trying to ruin my life.
I've been doing some research. You could write a victim impact statement.
Oh, here we go.
It would make a massive difference to his sentence.
Right, and do you know what else it'll make a massive difference to? My relationship with Perry. But she's barely even talking to me now.
But Perry needs Cameron. Maybe not at this minute, but she will at some point in her life. She still needs to have that option.
And what happens when my entire family disown me? Which they will do if I went through with this.
They forgive you. But Perry might not if you let Cam go. Leela, please. Prison would kill Cam again.
I wish I knew what was upsetting him so much.
I don't always feel like talking when I've been locked in a pub. You'll be all right after a good night's sleep.
Chelsea, Sam struggling to come to terms with Tiff's infidelity, and that old rumour mill's been churning over on E4 at 9. Then at 10, more murders, more cover-ups in brand new Scream Queens, E4's Funny Whodunit.
How about we all go downstairs so Jack can show us the ropes, yeah?
I'm actually a bit tired, Doug.
Me too.
Right, well, you two get an early night, and we'll finish the unpacking tomorrow, yeah?
Night, Mac.
Night.
Yeah, night.